and a sack of clothes. Free and easy down the road I go, hanging memories on the highline poles. Free and easy down the road I go, free and easy down the road I go. Up. Ragweed's rocking on the radio. Free and easy.
Floor exercise.
So I keep rolling like an old banjo. Free and easy down the road I go. Got the sunshine.
This is an example of a basic obstacle course used for beginning level recreation gymnastics. It's good for any child, able-bodied or disabled, of any disability.
Afford to roll down a cheese mat. Hopscotch. With lots of color. This mat can demonstrate how to do a cartwheel, showing where to put your feet in your hands. With the assistance of a coach, this mat can help learn a back walkover or a assisted forward roll. A tunnel to crawl through.
This board can help you learn balance and coordination.
A beginning level beam. Mini trampoline with a handle.
This course is designed to help build and reinforce fine motor skills. And it's also fun. Vault. Athletes of any ability can get used to using the springboard and vault with a coach's assistant. A coach will steady the gymnast's wrist to make sure that the vault is being performed safely and add a little stability.
Adding a mat under the springboard creates a wider base, and this is an easy adaptation for, say, a child with cerebral palsy who might have some issues balancing. So the wider base is going to give a lot more stability for a child to jump from the springboard onto the vault, and gives more cushioning, and in case anyone stumbles, the mat's going to provide a lot more safety and cushion for practicing. You can also add more mats of various sizes to boost the springboard higher to the vault. So it really depends on the child's level of comfortability and what works best for that particular athlete. This right here is another adaptive form of the vault. We still use the same springboard, but instead of leaping over the vault, you leap right onto these really cushy mats. And this is great because the vault can be a little intimidating, especially for beginner gymnasts. So using this, it provides a lot more comfort and safety as well.
Balance beam. Here we see Esther demonstrating a traditional balance beam walk used by most gymnasts. This balance beam walk can be adapted for really anyone. Here she's using a sidestepping walk, which is good for children with cerebral palsy. Another walk that children with cerebral palsy generally use is swinging their hips out and putting one foot in front of the other, like Esther is demonstrating right now. Another way to adapt the beam is to place two mats on either side, and this creates a good base in case anyone steps off the beam. And here Esther is again demonstrating a different type of balance beam walk that can be adapted for any child with a disability. For using the high beam, an adaptive way to do this is to place two mats underneath the beam, just in case anything would go wrong and an athlete would fall off. The mats would be there to catch them. These are just some balance beams that are generally used to train beginner athletes, and these are great for adapting balance beam to any student with a disability. the uneven parallel bars. Here, Esther demonstrates a traditional glide swing. The glide swing can be easily adapted to any athlete with muscular dystrophy or cerebral palsy using a simple bed sheet, as Esther is demonstrating here. Bed sheet becomes a swing that the athlete can glide swing in. Here, Esther demonstrates a traditional pullover. By using this large block mat, the pullover can be adapted for any athlete with a muscular disability. The mat provides support and gives a boosting off point for the pullover. And here Esther demonstrates a back hip circle. Using a simple bed sheet, the back hip circle can be adapted for any athlete with a disability. It will provide momentum and support. Something that doesn't need to be adapted is everyone's favorite event, the tumble track. Perfect 10! Special thanks to Global Gymnastics